Okay, so I made the 5 plus 3, so 6 with the blue bead. So now we're here on the end of the fourth row. We're going to insert the left string to this one adjacent bead, and here we're going to make a cluster of 5. So from here I'm going to slant the item to the left now. So what we're going to do is we're going to turn our project, insert 2 blue ones on the right and salikop with 1. So now our project is going to slant to the left. So insert your left string to the adjacent 1 bead. As you can see, and then we're going to make about 6 clusters of 5. Okay, so that is the start of the 5th row is 4 blue on the right, no, 3 only. 3 blue on the right and salikop with 1 blue. Then we're going to repeat this 5 more times. So you're just going to insert your left string to that adjacent 2 beads, and then I'm going to do the 5 clusters of 6 with the blue beads. And we catch up with you after that. Okay, so now that we finished the 6 clusters of 6 for the 5th row, we're going to the white part now. Insert your left string to the 2 adjacent beads, and we're going to have a slanting effect going to the left for this part. So what we're going to do is we're going to insert, or we're going to string a blue one, then a white, and we're going to salikop with a white bead. And then we're going to insert left string again to the 2 adjacent beads, and then we're going to put 2 beads on the right and then salikop with 1 white. And now we're on the last, on the end of the 5th row. So insert your string to the left, 2 adjacent beads, and then turn your work. And here, we're going to make a cluster of 6. So put 2 beads on the right, 2 white ones, silicop with the white. I'm going to the 6th row, so that is going to be that you insert the left string to 1 adjacent bead. I'm going to the right. Okay, so now we're going to put 3 white beads on your right string. I'm going to salikop with an orange one, so that is a 3rd star. And then insert your left string to the 2 adjacent beads. I'm hoping that our string this string is going to be enough for the last 2 rows. So since we're slanting, we're going to put 1 white, 1 blue on our right, and then salikop with the blue one for the slanting effect of the blue beads. Okay? So now we're going to insert the left string to this two adjacent leads, and we're going to make about 5 clusters of 6 in the blue, and then I'm going to show you how to do it on the side and to the upper part. I'm going to catch up with you after that. Okay, so now that we're finishing our 6th row now, stretch your left string to the two adjacent beads and then turn your work. So what you're going to do here is put two blue ones on the right string and then sleek up with the blue, and this will be the part where we put the cluster of 5 for the side parts that I shown you a while ago. So going up, so what you're going to do is you're going to make that cluster of 5. So in order to do that, we need to string two blue ones on the right and then sleek up with a blue one. Okay, so after this, you're going to make about 5 clusters of 6 in the blue. So that is, insert your left string to the two adjacent beads and you just make the next 5 clusters of 6, and I am going to catch up with you after that. Okay, so now that we finished the 5 clusters of 6 for the 7th row, we're going to close now with the first chick of this wallet. Insert your two left string to the adjacent two beads, and we're going to sleek up with string a blue and a white bead on the right, and then we're going to sleek up with both beads to close it, and then we're going to pass through our right string to a series of beads inside the wallet. So in order to close it or tighten it, just need to pull your string and pass through several beads inside. And this is also what you're going to do for the left string. So after this, you just have to make another cheek of this wallet, the same design. And then I'm going to show you how to connect the sides of it. Okay? So that's it. We need to do another one, and we're going to align it, and after that we're going to connect it on the sides, and then we're going to the part where we put the handle. So I'm going to show you that next time. I hope you finished it correctly. So that's it. Bye for now.